Hi, I'm Andy Waite. I'm a developer advocate working on the AdWords API.
And I'm Paul Matthews. I'm a developer programs engineer also working on the AdWords API.
Today we're going to talk to you about a feature that was introduced into the AdWords API recently called AWQL.
So what is AWQL? AWQL is an AdWords query language. It's a new feature introduced in v2012.06 of the AdWords API. It's SQL-like syntax for performing queries against the AdWords API, and it's an alternative to using generic selectors. It's available for selected AdWords API services, including campaign service, ad group service, and a few others. But most importantly, it's also for querying the Ad Hoc Reports.
So what is the motivation for introducing this new query language? So the traditional methodology used for querying or making queries against the AdWords API, generic selectors, can require quite a substantial amount of code. AWQL, as we will see in future slides, greatly simplifies that. Also, the AWQL syntax is much more intuitive for any developers that are already familiar with coding in SQL.
Okay, so let's start off with an example service call. In this instance, we're going to be calling the campaign service, and we're going to be trying to get hold of campaigns objects. So we're going to give it the criteria of a CTR of greater than 0.05, that's a click-through rate, and we're going to be looking for impressions over 100 and during the month of September 2012. So that's the sort of clause. And then we're going to sort the results by order of impressions. So this may be code that you're used to, but it'll be translated into whatever language you're most familiar in. And basically, this is the Java library for querying the AdWords API. So they're creating a predicate, a couple of predicates. We're adding these to selector, and we're querying the campaign service and getting back a page object. So that's the old code that you're familiar with, and as you can see, it's quite a lot of code to query quite a simple request. So this is the equivalent using the AdWords AWQL. And you can see you're again querying the campaign service, but we're using the query method, and we're passing in the string, which is similar to an SQL string. But the main difference here is that you don't have a from clause, and it's more tailored towards AdWords specific stuff. But as you'll see, you also get a page object back. So the response is the same as what you were used to in previous requests. And this is the alternative using the Python library, but it's a parameterized string. So this is probably more likely what you'd be using to query the service. Again, returning the page object. So let's break that down. To start off with, you're supplying a select where you pass in fields that you're interested in. You give it a where clause and the criteria that goes with that. During, you're giving it a sort of time period, and then you order by and give it the order of results you want, and finally limit. In this example, we're going to return the first 50 results.
Okay, so Paul's described to you how we use AWQL against the AdWords API services. And now I'm going to talk to you about how we would use AWQL against Ad Hoc Reports. Ad Hoc Reports are fairly simple to use. You don't actually need to use a client library to make queries against Ad Hoc Reports. Standard post request, HTTP post request will do. You'll supply some basic HTTP headers. For example, you'll provide authorization, content type, and client customer ID. And in the body of the post request, you will provide, for the old way of doing it, using report definitions, you'll provide an XML fragment, a key value pair, the key being underscore underscore RDXML, and the actual value being the XML fragment, which is your report definition. Using AWQL, it's very similar. You pass in the same headers, but we replace the underscore underscore RDXML with underscore underscore RD query. And this query, again, is a key value pair, the value being the query string. Because we cannot actually specify the query string, the download format within the query string, we have to specify it separately. So that's an additional parameter we have to add to the post body. In this case, it's underscore underscore FMT, and the parameter, the value for that will be the download format you require, for example, CSV or XML. You don't have to do it this way. You can use the AdWords API client libraries to do this for you. We have utility libraries that will actually write all this for you. And here's some examples. And now we're looking at a code example of how you would have done this with Ad Hoc Reports traditionally with generic selectors. And again, this is very similar to the code that Paul showed you for making queries against AdWords API services. In this case, we create a selector, we specify the fields we require, and then we assemble a report definition object, report name, date range type, what kind of report we require, and finally we set the download format. Then we use a utility library, report utils, and again this is Java code. We have a download report method on the report utilities library class, and we pass in an authenticated API user, a report definition object, which is the one we created earlier, and an output stream to where we want to actually write the response. How we would do that with AWQL, it's a lot simpler, a lot less code. Obviously in this case, if you look at it, this is a basic Java string. It's not parameterized anyway. It's a select statement. We specify the fields that we're interested in. In this case, we have to specify a from clause and the actual target table would be the reports that we want to make the query against. In this case, that's keywords performance report. We also want to specify in this particular example, we want impressions greater than zero. So we don't want rows that are zero impressions, and we want it for yesterday. We can parameterize that string. We can use string concatenation in Java, or we can use a string builder object. Or we can use a different language and use the kind of example that Paul showed you earlier. Then we can query or make a call against the report utilities library again, this kind of time we call download reports. We pass in the authenticated API user, this time we pass in the query string, and we also have to specify the download format. So this is goes back to the example we showed you with the post request, where we actually had to specify which format we required, because that could not be included in the query. And the last parameter to that call is the output stream we want to write the results to. So quickly breaking that down, similar to how Paul broke down the other example, we have a select statement. In this case, we have a mandatory from clause, and we have a where clause to define exactly what parameters we want to use to base the query on. And we always have to provide a during clause, which will specify the date range for which we want to pull statistics from the report service. So let's summarize some of the differences for ad hoc reports between ad hoc reports and making calls against the AdWords API services. As we've previously shown, you have to specify which report you want to make the call against or the query against, and this will be specified in the from clause of the query. Also, the during clause is mandatory. You have to specify a date range for which you want to make the query against. Also, because ad hoc reports do not support sorting and paging, we have to provide an order by and a limit. Oh, sorry, we cannot provide an order by and limits clause for these query statements. More details on the exact syntax of these queries can be found in the AWQL documentation at the following link. Paul's now going to summarize the differences between making AWQL queries against AdWords API services and against ad hoc reports.
Okay, so firstly, the regular service calls. So with the regular service calls, you do not submit a from clause. We mentioned it earlier. It's the main difference between ad hoc reports and service calls. Additionally, the during clause, the order by, and the limit are all optional, so you don't have to specify this. Then moving on to ad hoc reports, the during clause is mandatory. The from clause is also mandatory, so you know there's a lot more that you have to submit to an ad hoc report. And the order by and limit, as Manny just mentioned, are omitted because they cannot be used with the ad hoc reports.
Okay, so we talked about how we can use AWQL to make queries against AdWords API services and against ad hoc reports. So here's a few tips we put together about how we can make best use of AWQL. One of the key messages we want to pass on is that if you decide to replace your existing generic selector code with AWQL code, you don't have to actually change the way you process the results. Providing the queries are effectively the same, provide the same kind of results, then you can process them in exactly the same way. So you can just plug in your AWQL code to replace the generic selector code. Also, AWQL has a gigantically small impact on report generation performance. And so basically, you don't really have to worry too much about any performance decrease when you're using AWQL. And similarly, there is no actual difference in the cost in terms of API units between using generic selectors or AWQL. One thing we should mention, because of some of the query, the quirks of AWQL, there's a couple of parameters that are not supported in AWQL that you can use with generic selectors, particularly for specifying date ranges. You can't specify all time, not really quite sure why that is, and you can't specify custom date. Custom dates can be provided though, you just provide the date range as two separate separate time objects, date time objects, so that's not a problem, you just can't specify the actual clause custom date. So our call to action to you is to make sure that you use AWQL the next time you define a report query. And so the next one we can show is how we can do useful things with AWQL, like creating a command line interface tool for querying report data.
Okay, so we're going to step into a quick Cli Sample App Demo here. Excuse me, to show one way in which you could use the AWQL sort of feature. So this application is very, very small. It really didn't take a lot to write, and I encourage you to do the same if you're just curious about sort of trying out AWQL for the first time. So all this does is it passes the query off to the AWQL to the endpoints on the services. And in this case, we're going to be querying the ad hoc report. So the first thing I do when I get to this point is I want to sort of find the information about the table that I'm interested in querying. So for the argument's sake of this query, I'm going to be looking at querying the keywords performance report. So here on the keyword on the reports definition page, we have a list of all the fields that are available to us, along with some information in the right, some notes in the right hand column, the behavior and a lot of good information there for you. So I'd start off by navigating to this page and then choosing the table that I'm interested in. And one good way to find this is if there's something that you know the name of and you're trying to find out how to get all the information about it, is you can just use your regular built-in find for your browser. So we're going to be looking at keyword performance report. So then the next step would be to go through, find all the fields that you're interested in and decide what your criteria is for that particular report. I'm not going to go through and select it all out now, as that will take a bit too long, but I have got one that I've prepared earlier. So again, piping using that command line tool that I've prepared, I'm going to be selecting the ad groups, the keyword ID, the keyword text, the keyword match type, impressions, clicks, and cost from the keyword performance report. Next up, I want to specify my criteria, which in this case we're going to be using impressions greater than zero, which is the same as saying include zero impressions false. And then finally, we're going to say the during, because that's a mandatory field for ad hoc reports. So during last week. I'm going to query this report, and hopefully the results should be displayed to the screen for us in a CSV format. So what you can see here is the response back saying it's keyword performance report and the date of the query. Then the first line of the actual CSV is, as you'll see, the sort of the header columns. So ad group ID, keyword ID, keyword, match type, impressions, click, cost, which all correspond to the criteria, to the select clause that I fed into the query. And then you've got your results. So they exist down to the second to last line. And then finally on the last line, you have the totals if you are interested in that. So here we've got a few different keywords being displayed. And that concludes the demo of the simple AdWords CLI query app. And we may have to go step back into it. Okay.
Thanks, Paul. That was brilliant. So just to quickly mention, the report types documentation that Paul was looking at then is available in the AdWords API documentation, which you can easily find just by looking that up. So, having looked at how we can use AWQL against AdWords API services, and also how we can make use of AWQL against ad hoc reports, looking at a particular example, the command line interface into AWQL. Now we've pretty much finished and wrapped up, and we have the opportunity to let you ask some questions. You can answer the questions for us if you want to.
Yeah,
that might be more difficult.
Yeah, well, top contributors can get involved with that, I guess.
Yeah. So at the bottom there, we have a URL, a very short link URL, which we put on the first slide, but we forgot to tell you about. And you can use that slide, it's a moderator page, to enter questions. I'm not sure we can do live questions as well.
I don't think we've got the Hangout set up to ask live questions, so this time it's just...
Right, so we can't do live questions, but we can actually answer your questions on the moderator page. Next time we do this, we'll make sure we have the Hangout set up.
Yep.
So let's look at the moderator page. Paul, do you want to go for that?
Sure. Okay. No questions as yet.
Okay, so one of the questions I actually entered myself was, just to kind of get things going, was do we have to use a from clause with queries against API services or not? It seemed like there was no need to. Paul?
Yeah, so basically with the from clause from the API services, you don't need to for queries against the API services, you don't need to submit the from clause because that's implied by the service in which you are querying against. So for instance, if you're querying against the campaign service, you're going to be querying from that sort of pot of data, so you don't really need to specify a from clause.
Right, okay, so those services, those I think six services you identified on the second slide, they all have an additional method on them called query. So there's get, mutate, and now there's query on those services. Yep. And query, basically, if you're using query on the campaign service, then you don't need to say from the campaign service because that's implicit.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's brilliant.
Let's try refreshing the page. That might bring back some more results. We can remain hopeful.
Where are the presenters is a popular question as well. We're here.
We are here.
So let us know if you have any questions by entering on the moderator page.
Alternatively, if there are many questions left over after this this GDL, then we'll do our best to turn them into forum requests and then
So basically on that subject, we have the AdWords API Forum. We haven't linked to it here, but you can easily find it by searching on Google for AdWords API Forum. that's fairly easy to find, and we have that's manned by both Googlers and top contributors, so you'll get answers there. You can also ask questions on the YouTube page, and we can try and do our best to answer there. I assume comments will be open on there. That's good. So yeah, so thank you guys. Thanks for attending our Google Developer Live event today on AWQL, and we look forward to seeing you again in the future.
And just before we go.
Oh, just before we go, final slide. There's some other events coming up. If you do have any other questions that you want to ask, specific questions about AWQL or about anything else on the AdWords API, we have these things called office hours. Basically, we have a bunch of engineers sitting on the end of a hangout for an hour or so, and you can ask questions there. And these are the times and the schedules.
And this is a face-to-face, so you know, you'll get answers to your questions in real time, which can be really quite beneficial, and also open a dialogue where you can ask more than one question. And also, we mentioned sort of regions. So, for instance, America and New York on these office hours. But that's not to say that you can't join them from Europe to the New York ones. You know, they're open to everybody. It's just that the time zones suit the New York office probably best.
Yeah. Okay. So, thanks for joining us today, and we look forward to seeing you again in the future.
Thank you.
Thanks. Bye-bye.